This is a factoring video, factoring a trinomial into two binomials. Sometimes I call it undoing FOIL. But here we're going to focus where the leading coefficient is 1. So the form is going to be just x squared because there's a 1 right here. So understood 1. So x squared plus bx plus c. Now b and c can be positive or negative. We'll talk about that as we go through. I had a student this past semester, he called it the list method. I've been looking for a name that sounds just as good as anything, so we're going to call it the list method. Now, anytime you factor, remember you're supposed to have already identified what it is you're doing on this problem. So we have identified these as having 1, 2, 3 terms, and the leading coefficient is 1. Therefore, we will say it is the list method. So first, let's learn how to read these trinomials for factoring purposes. All right, if we can't read them, then we can't work them. And then before that, what I just talked about, if we can't recognize it, to even know we need to read it and work it, right? So here, we will read it from right to left. Now, I know that's backwards in the English language, but we're going to read it from right to left, and we will come back to the signs later. Okay, so some of y'all will be wondering that as we go through. We'll come back to those. So here there's 4 cases whenever there's a 1. If there's a 1 in the front here, right, then either this is a positive or a negative, and this is a positive or a negative. So we only have 4 cases. We have positive, positive. We have a negative. We have a positive and a positive. That's this sign and this sign, right? So we have that case there. We have also, what if this was a negative and this was a positive? That's case 2. Then what if this was a positive and this was a negative? So we flip it around. And then here, what if they're both negative for the fourth case here? What if they're both negative? So what I have done is I have put together 1 example of each one of these in this how-to video for factoring this kind of trinomial. So here's case 1, x squared plus 7x plus 10. There's a plus here and a plus here. That was our case 1. Now what case it is not important. How we learn to read it and how we deal with the signs is what's most important. So what we're going to do here is we're going to learn to read it. So we're first going to start at the right side, this 10 here. We're going to read this as the factors of 10. All right, the factors of 10. This is your list. All right, so the factors of 10. Now I'm going to remind you, factors multiply, right, to give you a product, right? So if you have a product, if you have 12, then the factors of 12 may be 3 times 4, or 2 times 6, or 1 times 12. Those are your factors. So here, how do you factor 10? Well, you have 1 times 10 and 2 times 5. Now, it's important. You can't put 1 with 5 or 2 with 10 because that doesn't give you 10 when you multiply it. So we need to be sure that we keep the factor sets together. 1 stays with 10, 2 stays with 5. So the factors of 10, that's how we start reading this, the factors of 10. The next thing we do is we go to the next thing here, this plus sign. So a plus sign means to add. So it's the factors of 10 that add. It's that simple. If this were a minus, we'd say that subtract. But here it's a plus, so we say that add. And then finally, to finish reading this, to give you 7. Now some of you say, Mr. Guest, I know there's a plus sign there. I'm disregarding that sign at this time. I'm going to come back to the signs. I know many of you were taught to think about the signs all at once, and that's fine, but some of you struggle with that. I know you do, and that's why you're on here trying to figure out how to factor. So I'm going to come back to the signs. There's rules for that. I like things that always work. If you can learn the rules in this video, they will always, always work. The numbers may get big, but they will always work. So we want the factors of 10 that add to give you 7. So if I look at this, let's come over here and talk about this. What do these add to? Well, what is 1 plus 10? It's 11. And 2 plus 5 is 7. Bingo. There's the ones I want. 2 and 5. So if I come down here, I'm going to start my 2 binomials, right? Factoring into 2 binomials, undoing FOIL. The first part, if I have an x squared out here, what has to come first in each one of these parentheses? That's right, x. If you don't have x times x, you don't get x squared. And every one of them that has x squared first, with a 1 as the coefficient, which is the list method we've already identified, is going to start out with x and x. Now we fill in the numbers. We already found out that they were 2 and 5. You put them in here in any order you want to. I know some of you may have been taught biggest first, smallest first. That's fine if that's what your teacher did, but you don't have to. It can be either number. What's important, the most important thing is, what do you put here, plus or minus? That's what will make this thing work. Okay, that's what drives the bus, so to speak. So we'll come back to the signs in a minute, but right now, the factors of 10 that add to give you 7 are 2 and 5. We'll come back to the signs, okay? Let's practice reading these some more. So right here, first we start with what? 14. We have x squared minus 9x plus 14. What does the 14 tell me? We want the factors of 14. The factors of 14, and again, this is your list, okay? Or gives you your list. So what are my factors of 14? Well, 1 and 14, I always like to start with 1 in the number, and then 2 and 3 and 4. Work my way up. It helps me make sure I don't skip anything. So does 2 go into 14? Sure, 7 times. What about 3, 4, 5, or 6? Nope. So the only sets of factors are 1 and 14, 2 and 7. And then again, we want them to do what? Add. That sign will always tell you what to do. Always. That add. That add to do what? To give you 9. And again, I know there's a negative there, but we're not worried about that sign right now. We'll come back to that sign in just a minute. If you can do the signs all at once, that's great, but we're going to come back to them. So the factors of 14 that add to give you 9. So let's come over here again. Let's write down the word add. And some of you can skip some of these steps, but again, I'm trying to show you everything here. Add. 1 plus 14 is 15. 2 plus 7 is 9. And bingo, we found it again. All right, we found it again. So down here again in my parentheses, we have an x and an x, right? The only way to get x squared is that way. And then this time I'm going to write my 9 first, but it doesn't matter if you write the bigger number first. I'm sorry, not the 9 first. That should be a 7. 9 is what we're trying to get. So 7 and 2, they add to give you 9. Again, I'm going to come back to pluses or minuses in here, all right? I'm going to come back to that. But we read it. The factors of 14 that add to give you 9. We'll worry about the negative later. The signs will take care of themselves if you learn the sign rules. So here, x squared plus 7x minus 30. If we read it again from right to left, we have here, this is what? The factors of 30. And this is your list again, or gives you your list. So then what are my factors of 30? Well, 1 times what? 30. Does 2 go into 30? Yes, an even number. 2 times 15, right? What about 3? 3 times 10. What about 4? 4 doesn't go into 30, right? What about 5? Anything that ends in a 0, 5 goes into. 5 times what? 6. And then when you get back to 6, you're 6 times 5, you already have it. So you don't keep going there. So there's your list of factors. Now we want to do what? This time we have a minus sign, so we don't want to add. We want to do what? That's right. We want to subtract. Subtract. Subtract to get what? 7. And we'll come back to that. Don't worry about positive 7 or negative 7. We'll come back to that. The factors that give you subtract to give you 7. So here I'm going to write sub because I don't have enough room to write subtract. So 30 minus 1 is 29. What is 15 minus 2? 13. What is 10 minus 3? 7. And when you find it, by the way, you could stop. But I'm going to go ahead and list them all out. 6 minus 5 is 1. But here it is, 3 and 10. And again, if you don't have to write that list of factors out, that's okay. Just setting that up for later in case we find one that maybe is a little more difficult. So here, again, we have to have what in each parenthesis? We have to have the x and the x, right? Got to have those to get the x squared. And then I'm going to write 3 and 10. But again, you could write 10 first and 3. What's important is that you get the right plus or minus here and here. But again, we're going to come back to the signs. We are going to come back to the signs after we read them. So here, the factors of 30 that subtract to give you 7 are 10 and 3. So we have everything in the answer here set up. We just don't have the signs yet, but we're going to come back to that. And then finally, the fourth case, because we've done the first three cases, is going to be x squared minus 3x minus 18. So if we start reading this, we want the factors of what? 18. The factors of 18. And again, this is your list. So we have 1 and 18. We have 2 and 9. Does 3 go into 18? 3 and 6. What about 4 and 5? Nope. So that's all your factors of 18. And what do we want our factors to do this time? Again, there's a minus. That means what? That's subtract. That's subtract. Let's subtract to do what? To give you 3. Mr. Guest, that's a negative. I know. We'll come back to the signs. There are nice basic signs for the rules that will always make it work. The signs are typically the most difficult thing of this. Most people can get the number in the middle. They just can sometimes get confused on the signs. So we want to subtract to give us 3. So if we come over here again, I'm going to write sub for subtract. We have 17 because 18 minus 1 is 17. 9 minus 2 is 7. 6 minus 3 is 3. And so there it is. We found it. And if you factored anything at all, you know that it doesn't have to work, but these are all working right now. So here we have x and x, and the numbers that work were 3 and 6. And again, it doesn't matter which one goes first, as long as you get the signs correct. You know, plus 3 minus 3, plus 6 minus 6, whichever one it happens to be. So again, the factors of 18, we go the factors of 18 that subtract to give me 3. And then we go from there. All right, so we've read them. We know how to read them now, all four cases. So let's move to the signs. Let's focus on the signs. So when we have x squared plus bx plus c, really this plus b, that could be plus b or minus b. It could be a positive or negative number. Same thing here. That could be a positive or negative number, hence the four cases, right? So what I want to do is I want to actually start here. You're going to read from right to left again. How the signs are related in the factored form is this right here, all right? How they're related. So if this sign here is a plus, we say they're the same. And if this sign's a minus, they're different. Okay? That's plus is the same, minus is different. And this goes back to adding and subtracting numbers. You weren't taught this probably. I wish we had taught this way in first and second grade when you did addition and subtraction. If two signs have the same number, if two numbers have the same sign, you add them. If two numbers have different signs, you subtract them. And then if you subtract, you take the sign of the larger number. But you weren't taught this when you were taught 9 minus 6. 9 is positive, 6 is negative. You put them together, you get a positive 3 because 9 is bigger. You did that, but you weren't taught it that way. I wish we had done that from the beginning, but we don't. So the same signs, if it's a plus there, it doesn't matter how these two things relate. That doesn't matter. I'm talking about in the answer, in the two parentheses that we built on the four previous pages, is it going to be both positive the same or both negative the same, or is one positive, one negative different? That's what I mean by plus or minus. And then this part tells you what the signs are in the factored form. So let's see how that looks here. The same sign is positive. If this is positive, they're the same. If this is a positive, they're the same. If that's a negative, they're different. And I mean in the answer. Okay? Oops, wrong one. So we read it as both. If this is a plus, we read it as both. If this is a minus, we read it as bigger. Okay? Bigger or both. And once we do that, we go back and read this sign here. So if this is a plus, it's both whatever this is, or if this is a minus, it's bigger number gets whatever's up front. All right? So let's practice reading that here on this one. So first of all, we look only at this sign here. And it is a what? It is a positive, a plus, right? This is a plus. So that tells me I read it as both. They're the same. Right? In my mind, I say the same. Out loud, I say both. If I'm saying it out loud, I say both. Both what? Both. So this says both, this sign right here. Both positive. Both positive. So when I do that, I end up with both of these things being plus. Again, if I have x squared plus 7x plus 10, this says both positive, okay? Both positive. This also says the same. you just cover this up. It doesn't matter what that is. That plus says they're the same in the answer. That means this and this are identical. They're the same. That's what that means. Okay? So now if you were to FOIL out this answer I just boxed, you would end up with what we started with. It would end up with what we started with. So here, again on the signs, is this going to be the same or different? It's the same. Remember, I read that in my mind that way. So I have x squared plus, nope, not plus, minus 9x plus 14. So that means the signs are the same. I don't mean this and this. They're obviously different. That's not what I mean. I mean down here, this and this are the same. That's what a plus tells me. The only way to get a positive 14 is if you multiply two pluses or two minuses. If the signs are different, you get a negative, right? It goes back to basic multiplication rules. So here, this says the same. So how do I read that? Both. Both what? Both negative. Which means down here in my answer, I get a minus and a minus. They're both negative in the answer. Not in the problem. It's obvious in the problem that one's minus and one's plus. I mean in the answer, they're both negative. Right down here in what I'm about to box right here, that's both negative. Again, if I FOIL this out, I end up with x squared. I end up with a minus 2x and a minus 7x, and that gives me minus 9x. It gives me my middle term. And then when I do the L of FOIL, I get negative 7 times negative 2 is positive 14, and it works out. This method always works if you can read both or bigger with the first sign. So let's look at one with a minus there. So what does this now tell me? This says they are different. In my mind, I say they're different, right? In my mind, I say they are different. Not because they're different here. That doesn't mean anything. Only this sign right here. You just cover this one up and forget it's there. That says different no matter what's in the front there. So when I do this, x squared plus 7x minus 30, this we read out loud as bigger. Bigger what? Bigger gets a plus. Now when we say bigger, we're talking about 3 and 10. Which one's bigger? The bigger number is 10, right? The bigger number there is 10. So 10 gets a what? It gets a plus. And what does 3 get? A minus because they are different. They're different. The 3 gets a minus because they're different. Again, if you FOIL this, you get x squared, then you get a plus 10 minus 3 gives you the plus 7x in the middle, and then you get minus 30. So that works out. Again, if you can learn the rules for the signs, which that's the hardest part of this, it will always, always, always work. You don't have to learn these rules. You can factor it a different way, but this is the way that it will work every single time. All right, so here, what does this tell me? Same or different? Different. Remember, right here, this and this are the same. That's not what I'm asking you. I'm asking you here and here, they're the same or different. They are different because of that minus sign. So when we have that, this we read as the bigger number. And then the bigger number gets what here? A minus, right? The bigger gets a minus here because this is a minus, right? That's why the bigger number gets a minus. So when I do this, which one of these numbers is bigger? The bigger number is 6, right, between this one and this one. So the bigger gets a negative. So what does the 3 get? A positive. So again, if you were to FOIL this out, you would get x squared. You would get a minus 6x and a plus 3x gives you your minus 3x in the middle. Then you get a plus 3 times a negative 6 is negative 18. All right, so I hope this has helped you learn to factor these. I call this the list method. Good luck with your algebra pursuits, and thanks for watching.